How's it going, people? This is Michael. I have a couple of good news. I now have 100 subscribers, and I have just traded in my CBR125R for a 2013 Honda CBR250RA. In this video, I'm going to be drawing comparisons between the two bikes based on my first impressions and my limited experience as a new rider. I made a couple of videos of me on my CBR125R. And while it was a good bike for me to learn on, I felt that I needed a little more power, a little more weight, and ABS. I found this bike on GP Bikes listed for much lower than other private listings on Kijiji. It was also my favorite color out of the other possible color combinations. So I received the bike with no scratches, but within 3 days I dropped it on my driveway beside my car, scratching both the bike and my car. So I stood there for several minutes cringing with a sick feeling in my stomach. Luckily the scratches were minor except for the black exhaust, which now has obvious scratches. But before the drop I had already ordered an aftermarket exhaust, and I'll be posting a separate video for that once I install it. So anyway, I found many similarities to the CBR125R. For instance, the body style is so similar that to the untrained eye, you cannot tell which bike is which. The dashboard cluster is also identical except for the speedo display, which now has a blue backlight, which I really prefer. The seat heights are also the same, but the seating position is slightly more upright on the 250, and the foot pegs are lower. On a couple of 30-minute trips, I could tell right away that I can ride this bike longer because the seating position felt more comfortable. Many buttons and levers have a more premium look and feel than the 125. For example, the headlight controls use rocker switches instead of the slide switches, and they're also larger. Instead of a large hole on the 125, the ignition keyhole has a spring-loaded door and is flush with the crossbar. I had only taken a 250 for a test drive on first gear when I borrowed a riding buddy's bike for a ride around a parking lot. When I rode off the lot for the first time on this bike, I was very careful not to twist too hard. Immediately, I could feel that this bike had a lot more power than the 125. I can now stay longer in the lower gears when riding around town, although the fun factor of frequent gear shifts is still there. I had taken this bike on Highway 401 for a short ride just to test it, and it gave me comfort that the RPMs were much lower than the 125 at 100 kilometers per hour. With a slightly larger frame, longer wheelbase, larger tires, and ABS, this bike is 50 pounds heavier than the 125. This was evident on the highway test ride, as I felt more stable at highway speed, and this additional weight was also the reason why I sprained my wrist after I stood up the bike after I dropped it on my driveway. Finally, the availability of ABS is the final reason why I wanted to upgrade. A week after getting my license, I was riding my 125 when it started to rain. I was 5 minutes away from home, so I turned back. But as I was slowing down on my approach at a red light, the rear tire locked after I hit a slick patch at 40 kilometers per hour. When I released the brake, the bike began to fishtail at 30 kilometers per hour through the intersection. I was lucky that the intersection was just a three-way intersection, and the driver saw me struggling and then let me through the intersection without incident. ABS is not available on the 125. I was also surprised that my insurance premiums became slightly lower despite the increase in displacement. There are only a couple of things that I wish was different on the CBR250. First, I think that the kickstand is too short, making the bikes lean too upright. This was the reason why I dropped my bike in the driveway. As I was dismounting, the bike leaned the other way. Now I have to be extra selective of slope before I use the kickstand. The second are the headlights. The 125 had those halo projector lights, which I thought was pretty cool. I wish they used the same ones on the 250. Overall, this bike has been as much fun to ride as the 125, but with the added benefit of more power, more weight, and the security of ABS. In a couple of weeks, I'll be installing my Delcovic exhaust and will be posting a video about it. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.